Zips with a record of 5-6. Good evening, everyone. I'm Alan Davis, along with my partner, probably one of the most popular players to ever wear a Cleveland Cavaliers uniform, Mr. Bingo Smith. And Bingo, tonight the Vikings are coming off a loss, playing against a team that is also coming off a loss, the Akron University Zips.
Well, I think the Vikings tonight is playing a team that's in a tailspin. They're in a two-year probation period. Last year, they only had one recruit, and he's a junior college transfer that's All-American in Merchant. Have a new coach in Bob Huggins, so he has to try to bring this program back in the next couple of years.
Not only are they on probation, they also lost about 50% of their offense from last year.
That's right. I forgot about that guy. He's talking about Joe Kubik. He was all the offense for the Zips last year.
Of course, the Vikings lost a tough 75-72 decision to the Illinois-Chicago Flames. The problems, again, at the free throw line, where they only shot 52% on a 12 out of 23 performance.
Well, I got to work with them on that again. We got to go back to the first of the season, get these guys back shooting good free throws. But I think what they're looking for tonight is finally put the final piece to that puzzle together. They've proven to themselves they can play with the best. They took Maryland down to the wire. They took the AMQ champs last year, Illinois, Chicago, down to the wire and lost, as you said, the free throw line. So tonight they're going to try to put that final piece of the puzzle together so they can go to the AMQ tournament, hopefully at the end of the year, and win it.
Okay, the tip-off comes up in just a few minutes between this backyard rivalry and the Akron University Zips and the Cleveland State Vikings. Stay tuned. We'll be back. Physical Education Center on the campus of the University of Akron. Let's get the starting lineups from our public address announcer, Don Reed.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here are tonight's starting lineups. For the Vikings, Cleveland State University at guard, a 5'8", 155-pound sophomore, number 4, Sean Hood. At the other guard for the Vikings this evening, a 6'2", 170-pound junior, number 22, Vince Richards. At forward for the Vikings this evening, a 6'6", 210-pound junior, number 24, Clinton Smith. At center for the Vikings this evening, a 6'9", 225-pound freshman, number 30, Eugene Miles. Rounding out the Vikings starting lineup at forward, a 6'4", 205-pound sophomore, number 44, Clinton Ramsey. The Vikings are coached by head coach Kevin Mackey. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here are the 1985 University of Akron Zips. At guard, a 6'2", 180-pound junior from Oberlin, Ohio, number 10, James Merchant. At the other guard for the Zips this evening, a 6'3", 165-pound sophomore from Galleon, Ohio, number 43, John Lawyer. At forward, a 6'6", 210-pound sophomore from Mentor, Ohio, number 32, Doug Schutz. At the other forward, a 6'2", 185-pound senior from Napoleon, Ohio, number 45, Dave Smith. Rounding out the Akron starting lineup at center, a 6'7", 245-pound senior from Sandusky, Ohio, number 00, Brian Roth. The Zips are coached by head coach Bob Huggins.
Very good.
There are your starting lineups for tonight's contest between the Akron University Zips and the Cleveland State Vikings. Interesting story. If the name Doug Schutz rang a bell, he played for the Cleveland State Vikings 2 years ago, the last year that Ray Derringer was head coach, the team that went 8-20, and had his career-high game in college against these very same Akron Zips, scored 23 points and 13 rebounds. That was back on February 8th of 1983. So let's hope that Turnabout is not fair play tonight and that he doesn't do the same thing against his former teammates here on the Viking squad. We're still waiting for the Zips to take the floor. Repeating your starting lineup once again, Clinton Ramsey, Eugene Miles at center, and Clinton Smith at the other forward, Vince Richards and Sean Hood at the guards, and the Zips counter with Schutz and Smith at the forwards, Roth at the center, Merchant and Lawyer at the guard positions. Ready now for the tip-off. The Zips 5-6 coming off two straight losses. The Vikings, of course, coming off that heartbreaking 75-72 loss against Illinois Chicago as James Merchant puts up the first 2 points of the ball game this evening, and it is quickly a 2-0 Akron Zip lead. James Merchant, the second leading scorer on the squad with a 13.7 point per game average.
Right off the bat, the Zips went right to the hoop. A nice fast break on the tip.
And Clinton Ramsey equals that with a nice layup underneath. And it's a 2-2 ball game. We've only played 30 seconds of basketball here. The Vikings quickly on the press, shoots with a basketball to Merchant, then to Roth, and now on the front court to our Lawyers.
The Zips didn't take advantage of a 2-on-1 fast break that time. They slowed it down to get a good, decent shot.
Smith from long range, and he makes it 4-2 in favor of the Akron University Zips. As we mentioned at the top of the show, the Zips are going to have to recover. There's a steal by Dave Smith, and he hands off the Lawyers. The Zips are recovering from some probation problems. They're only allowed to recruit one player. They've lost a lot of scholarships. Schutz underneath, has it rejected by Miles, but Miles also clips him on the arm and commits the first foul of the ball game.
Miles gave good help on the baseline that time. Ramsey went for the steal. Miles over for the block. His hand came forward. If his hand had it went straight up, I don't think he would have got a call for a foul on that.
A little bit of first game aggressiveness, or not first game aggressive, but early game aggressiveness, we should say. Shoots at the free throw line, missing on his first attempt. He's shooting 77% from the free throw line so far on the season.
Cleveland State lost to Illinois Chicago, trying to make a bounce pass to the post. You saw first pass into the post tonight was a bounce pass and it was stolen. Let's see how they react to that.
The Zips now lead 5-2 as Schutz with the pair. Ramsey on the turnaround, no good, and Roth coming down with the rebound. Big double zero, averaging 8.9 rebounds per game. 98 total on the season. Roth on the right side, missing underneath on the rebound. The foul will be on either Merchant or Smith.
You'll see that most of the night where the Zips will send two or three men to the board. They're short on height out there, so they have to rely on hustle and everyone going to the board.
And that foul was called on Dave Smith, his first, the team's first personal. So both teams even in the foul category. Sean Hood driving the lane.
Very fine move by Sean. In the last game against Illinois Chicago, I think he had one shot for the whole ball game. So he's matched his output for that game already.
James Merchant, the second leading scorer on the Zip squad. Also second leading rebounder. Underneath, Roth off the rim, no good, and knocked out of bounds, and it'll be Cleveland State basketball.
Not a bad move by Roth that time. Good head and shoulder fake. Went up strong with the basketball, just a little hard off the glass.
Roth, a big man at 6'7", 245. He's being looked at by the Dallas Cowboys, I understand, as a potential linebacker. And I'd say with that body size, he'd be a good bet to make it. Vince Richards from the left side puts it up and in. We've talked a lot about Vince Richards and the outside shot, and he's probably the best outside shooter on the squad. He doesn't take the shot often enough, as you've mentioned before.
I think they have to take that outside shot to open it up inside. That way you can get a good pass into Miles.
Roth was called for traveling there. You saw him drag his pivot, but it'll give the ball back to Cleveland State. It's a 6-5 ball game. The Vikings on top with 17 minutes and 2 seconds remaining in the first half.
The first four times down the floor, the Vikings entered the ball on the right side. They're doing it again. They should change up and bring it to the other side of the floor, give a different look to their offense.
Miles on the turnaround misses and gets called for the foul on the rebound. So that's two personals on Miles. And now the substitution express begins. Bob Crawford, Eric Mudd, Eddie Bryant all coming in, replacing Smith, Richards, Hood, and Miles. Where was the fourth substitution? Tyrone Kingwood was in there. So we'll catch all those numbers for you as the game goes along. Merchant trying to squeeze in around the trap, and Kingwood right away gets called for the blocking foul. Tyrone Kingwood, number 31. Commits his first personal, the team third. Roth.
We missed it, but on that trap there, if you're going to trap somebody in the corner, you must come together, the two defensive personnel, and not let him split the gap.
On the far side, Merchant. To Lawyers, to Schutz, and Roth. Underneath the attempt to Merchant goes out of bounds. It'll be Cleveland State basketball. Let's pick up that lineup for you once again. Number 33 is Eric Mudd. He is now in the ballgame, along with number 5, Eddie Bryant, whom you'll see getting the basketball there. And also then Tyrone Kingwood, 31, Bob Crawford, number 40, at the center. And Crawford with the basketball. Has it knocked away and almost stolen. And let's see in the scramble, Akron University comes away with it. Doug shoots with the basketball. The Zips trail 6-5 with 16 minutes remaining in the first half of action. The Zips have yet to make a substitution. They have their original starting lineup in there. But they will make a few substitutions as the game goes along. They have not had a set lineup all season as Coach Bob Huggins in his first year tries to find a winning combination. From the far side, Lawyer is missing, and coming out with the rebound is Tyrone Kingwood. Ramsey pulls up and it goes over the top of the backboard. It'll be the Vikings, the Zips basketball rather. There's an official timeout on the floor with 15 minutes, 36 seconds remaining in the first half. The score, Cleveland State 6, Akron University 5. We'll be back. Center on the campus of the University of Akron so far in the ball game. The Vikings have taken 6 shots from the field. They've converted 3 of them for 50%. Akron U 2 out of 5 for 40%. Each team has committed 2 turnovers. CSU has 3 team fouls. The University of Akron has 1 so far, and that one is on Dave Smith. It'll be Akron University's basketball, and Doug Schutz takes it inside to Mr. And Clinton Ramsey getting called on the foul there. That is the 4th team foul on the Vikings, the first foul on Clinton Ramsey.
Well, the Zips did the thing you have to do. You have to go over the press. They tried to get the ball to midcourt. It was a foul on the play.
Dave Smith was the player fouled. Shoots into Roth. And back to Smith, and we have a backcourt violation. Roth was already past the midcourt line. And those are the kind of turnovers that the press that Cleveland State plays is supposed to force. Eddie Bryant in the corner to Ramsey, back to Bryant, to Kingwood. Kingwood going to drive the lane. Stops and pops, no good. And Crawford coming out with the rebound. Bob Crawford on the turnaround, falls short. And let's see, they're going to call the foul on James Merchant, who came down with the rebound. Check it. No, it is on Crawford. So Crawford commits the personal, his first, the team 5th now. And we have played 5 minutes of basketball here, and the Zips have only scored 6 points, but it's good enough for a 1-point lead, 6-5, over the University of Akron. Dave Smith brings it into the front court and gives off to John Lawyer. James Merchant. Back to Smith. Underneath it goes to Merchant. Merchant on the turnaround. Ball goes in, and there's going to be a foul. It'll be on Eric Mudd.
Here, as you see, Merchant post up. Up strong with the basketball. Kingwood did not reach out, but his body contact underneath. They call the foul underneath.
That is Tyrone Kingwood's 2nd personal of the ball game. And Merchant makes it a 3-point play and gives the Zips an 8-6 lead now. with 14 minutes and 55 seconds remaining. Crawford is going to be fouled by Dave Smith. Smith called for his second personal of the ball game, the second team foul against the Zips. Fans here didn't agree with that call. They thought it was a little bit late.
I actually thought Bob should have released the ball toward the hoop. He would have been going to the line right now.
That's right.
But that'll come with experience. He's back for this semester. He missed the first part of the season.
And, of course, his first season of Division I ball. As Kingwood drives the lane, and he is fouled again by Smith. And real quickly, Dave Smith has gathered three personal fouls. And right away, the Zips make a substitution. They're going to bring in number 33, Rick Accord, a 6'5", 185-pound senior from Findlay, Ohio, to replace Dave Smith in the lineup.
On this move, Kingwood had already decided to go to the hoop. He was up in the air. He had braced himself to go up for the shot, and it was a foul call.
Zips now on defense. Vikings get the ball underneath their own basket. Eddie Bryant works it to Clinton Smith, and Smith takes a shot from the corner. No good. Roth coming down with the rebound. The Zips on the attack. They lead 8-6 with 14:21 remaining in the first half. Rick Accord over to Doug Schutz. Now to Roth. Roth driving the lane. Up. Good. High shot, and Roth has his first 2 points of the ball game. And it's a 10-6 Akron lead as Sean Hood and Vince Richards getting set to come back into the lineup along with Eugene Miles.
For a big man, Roth has very good fundamentals. Good head and shoulder fake, straight up in there. He used the glass and everything on that shot.
Eric Mudd, no good. Tyrone Kingwood on the rebound, loses it out of bounds. And the subs come in now. Miles, number 30, Hood, number 4, and Richards, number 22, replacing Crawford, Kingwood, and Bryant. John Lawyer. Speaking of Roth, they say he bench presses quite a bit. I didn't get the exact poundage, but he is strong, built like a horse. Losing the ball out of bounds there.
Not a bit of fat on him either.
No. 6'7", 245 pounds. Was a starter at Toledo University his freshman year, transferred from Toledo, and sat out last year. He leads the club in scoring, 156 points for a 14.2 average. And Miles puts up the shot, misses, but he is fouled by John Lawyer. The fourth team personal for the Akron University Zips.
On this shot here, a very fine pass into Eugene. As you notice, no head and shoulder fake there. That's something he has to work on. That'll come with a little more maturity. Get head and shoulder fake, then go up strong for the bucket.
Eugene Miles will be at the line for two shots. Eugene shooting 60.4% from the free throw line. And he misses on his first attempt. Eugene was on a tear at one point. Canned 18 of 19 from the free throw line. Has hit a bit of a slump recently. Splits the pair there. Has his first point of the ball game, and it's now a 10-7 ball game. Akron University on top with 13:16 to go in the first half of action here at the Health and Physical Education Center on the campus of the University of Akron. Nice facility. Seat 7,000. Brand new season. I believe this is the first year that they've been playing in it. Doug Schutz underneath, getting the pass and putting it up and in.
They show a lot of patience. They showed a lot of patience that time. Excuse me, Alan. That shows what you can do if you have patience and wait for your shot to materialize.
Eugene Miles on a turnaround, no good. Merchant coming down with the rebound. It's 12-7. The Zips with the ball and a 5-point lead. Roth pulls up, puts it up and in. Ryan Roth now with 4 points, and the Zips have doubled the output of the Cleveland State Vikings. 14-7 with 12:18 remaining in the first half. Glenn Smith driving the baseline, has it blocked by Schutz, but it'll still be the Vikings ball as the ball goes out of bounds. Substitution for the Akron University Zips, Darius Moss, number 51, a 6'7", 215-pound junior from Bedford, played his high school ball at Chanel. And Clinton Ramsey also back in for the Vikings, replacing Eric Mudd. Underneath, the ball is kicked by Akron U. It'll remain the Zip basketball, or rather the Vikings basketball. Clinton Ramsey up off the glass and in, his fourth point of the ball game now, and it's a 14-9 Akron University lead. Merchant trapped by Ramsey, or rather Smith and Richards, gets away from it though. Rob's pass almost stolen by Richards, but Akron University retains possession. Merchant driving the lane. He's fouled before the shot by Sean Hood.
It was a very good pick by Roth that time. He said a big, strong pick. The defensive personnel took the back route. That's why he was late there for the shot. As you see, he went to the back of the pick. Actually, it was Sean Hood who was helping out on the play, came from the other side.
And Merchant will be at the line for two shots. I'm sort of surprised on the replay. It didn't seem like he had gone into his motion, but I guess that after he'd stopped dribbling, they count that as continuous motion. Merchant now 2 of 2 from the line so far. Came into the ball game shooting 73%. Has a chance now to make it 3 of 3, and he does. And there's an official timeout on the floor now with 11 minutes and 44 seconds remaining. The score, Akron University 16, Cleveland State 9, Wilton University Zips, and their youthful coach, Bob Huggins, only 31 years old, named head coach less than a year ago, back on March 28th of 1984, became the 18th head coach in the university, in Akron University history, I should say, and the second youngest head coach at the time. Leading scorer so far for the two ball clubs, James Merchant has 7 points for Akron U. He's followed by Brian Roth with 4 and Doug Schutz with 3. Cleveland State, Ramsey has 4. Hood and Richards have 2 points each. And Eugene Miles, 1 point. As Vince Richards is back into the lineup, that is he with the basketball now over to Sean Hood. Across court, Ramsey to Richards, back to Hood, and over to Ramsey, now to Smith. As the Vikings pass around the perimeter, they've been doing a lot of that. Underneath, Clinton Smith all alone puts it up and in.
Very good pass by Vince Richards from the top of the circle. They're trying to deny Vince that shot at the top of the circle, so someone has to rotate up top. That's leaving someone free down underneath.
But it shows what patience on offense can do, and that's something that's hard, I guess, for these guys from Cleveland State to adjust to, because they're so used to playing at the breakneck pace that Kevin has them playing at, and it's kind of hard to change up, especially when you're as young as the Vikings are. Brian Roth, good block by Clinton Smith. Good defensive effort. Clinton Ramsey driving the lane. He is fouled. And I believe that'll be on Merchant.
Here's the block here on Roth's shot. You see Smith hung in the air and caught that ball. He was actually coming down when he blocked that shot. Good fast break. The ball was given to Clinton Ramsey in the middle of the court. He went in for the shot and was fouled.
The foul was on number 43, John Lawyer, and he is replaced right away by Mike Fenwick, a 6-foot senior out of St. Vincent St. Mary's High School here in Akron. Transfer from Slippery Rock, Pennsylvania. Ramsey at the line where he's shooting 78.8%, missing on the first attempt. Clinton Ramsey went 6-for-10 from the free throw line against Illinois Chicago the other night, and he was out here very early this afternoon. In fact, when we arrived, he was already in uniform and practicing his free throws. It shows what kind of a work ethic this fellow has.
Well, the trick to free throw shooting is to get the ball to die in the hole, so you won't have any live, if you have a live rim, it will not come out.
Eugene Miles is fouled by Darius Moss, who just came into the ball game. Darius Moss from Chanel High School in Cleveland.
Here you see the fast break into the middle of Sean Hood. Good pass to Miles. See, he stopped on that fast break. He stopped about 2 or 3 feet short of the bucket. If he had kept running, he could have had a clear layup.
Miles at the line, makes good on both. And it is now a 16-13 ball game. Akron U still on top by three with 10-17 remaining. Long pass down to Rick Accord.
Get out of here.
Fenwick to Merchant. As the Zips now pass around the perimeter. Merchant gets away and puts up a reverse layup, which misses, and Vince Richards comes out with a rebound to Eugene Miles. Miles on the drive off the glass, and he's called for the offensive foul.
I disagree with that call, but I see why the official made the call. Miles stopped again on this fast break. As you see, he stopped, gave the defensive personnel time to actually get his position.
But Fenwick was actually sliding the leg out when the whistle was made, but nevertheless, Eugene is now quickly sitting down on the bench with three personal fouls in the first 10 minutes of action here at the Health and Physical Education Center on the campus of the University of Akron. Vikings trail 16-13 to the Akron University Zips. Accord shooting and missing, and coming out with it is Clinton Ramsey. Put to Richards. Richards high off the glass, missing. And Accord comes down with the rebound. First half of action as you're watching Cleveland State basketball on WCLQ TV 61. And next Saturday night, we'll be back with you once again as Darius Moss makes a field goal. And it's 18-13 now, CSU. We will be in Cedar Falls, Iowa to bring you the game between the Vikings and the Northern Iowa Panthers.
Right now, Cleveland State is getting a little lackadaisical out there. They're making sloppy passes. I think we have to be crisp, even when we play a team that's in a position like Akron.
James Merchant missing, but the ball tipped out by Accord into the hands of teammate James Fenwick. And the Zips maintain possession. Fenwick all alone misses the bunny. Crawford coming down with the rebound. Vikings on the attack. Sean Hood stopping up and slowing down the action as we get a whole bunch of substitutions getting set to come in. Richards from long range, no good. And underneath, it's knocked out of bounds. It'll still be Cleveland State basketball. Steve Corbin, number 21, making his first appearance in three ball games for the Vikings, replacing Vince Richards. Eddie Bryant coming back in, also replacing Sean Hood.
On that shot by Richards, he was a little further out than he really thought he was. He was about 23, 24 feet out. Good dunk.
And while we were away, Bob Crawford just slammed one in to make it 18-15. The Vikings down by three. Crawford's first 2 points of the ball game. Into the ball game for the Akron University Zips, number 55, Chris Kelly, a 6'4", 210-pound sophomore from Lorain Catholic. And also Brian Roth back into the ball game.
I think Kelly can get Roth to go for body weight there. He's an ex-football player.
Doug Schutz is called for the offensive foul, and so the Zips lose the basketball. Schutz first personal. The seventh team foul for the Akron University Zips. 7:36 remaining in the first half of action here on the campus of the University of Akron. An official timeout on the floor with a score. Akron 18. Mackey in his second year with a record of 22-21 now after that 75-72 loss to the Illinois Chicago Flames last Monday night. A game which we brought you here on WCLQ. Shooting percentages so far for the ball game. Nothing to write home about. The Vikings 6 of 19 for 31.6%. The Zips 7 of 15 for 46.7%, and that is the difference in the ball game right now. The score 18-15, the Zips on top by three with 7:30 remaining in the first half. Eddie Bryant shooting from the top of the circle, off the glass or off the rim, no good. There's a foul underneath, and it's going to be another call on Doug Schutz, who has all of a sudden captured the attention of one of our officials tonight.
I think it's just hustled by shoots here. He tries to get the inside position. You see his elbow was up, but his hands were not up. If your hands are straight up, then they can't call that foul. His hands was out in front, so they give an appearance that you're pushing off.
Clinton Ramsey will be at the line where he is 0-for-2 right now as Darius Moss replaces Doug Schutz in the zip lineup. Ramsey with 4 points so far on the night, averaging 19.5 points per game on the season. And Ramsey missing three in a row, very uncharacteristic of the sophomore from Toledo Maycomber High School. The Zips get the rebound and they are on the attack now, leading by three. And Darius Moss taking the shot, missing. Ramsey coming down with the rebound. The Vikings now on the attack. Pulling up is Ramsey, missing, but coming down with the rebound. Eric Mudd going back up, puts it in, and he is fouled.
Eric Mudd, again, doing his job. He does this better than anybody I know. That offensive rebound and put it back in. As you see here, a good fast break, delayed fast break. Ramsey takes the jump shot. As you see, Mudd inside with good inside position. Back up for the foul.
And that is Chris Kelly getting called for the personal foul as Mudd makes it a three-point play. And it is now a tied ball game, 18-18 with 6:50 remaining. Brian Roth giving off to Kelly. Kelly almost losing the basketball. Chris Kelly, 55, a walk-on from the football team this year. Several walk-ons on this Akron University squad, four of them to be exact. Kelly from long range on the sideline, no good. Roth coming down with a rebound. Roth on the turnaround, puts it up and in. 6 points for Brian Roth. And the Zips go back out on top, 20-18 with 6:13 remaining. Clinton Smith. A little bit low off the glass, and Akron University comes away with the basketball.
That time, Clinton Smith got a very good pass, good head and shoulder fake, but then he leaned back. He should go straight to the hoop.
Well, I think the intimidating factor there is Brian Roth underneath at 6'7", 245. You really don't want to tussle with him, but Smith this time goes up, puts it in, and he will be fouled by James Fenwick, number 25, getting up off the ground there.
Here we see the fast break. As you see, Clint Smith went to the outside very fast to the lane with his left hand. In for the points and a foul. Here we see it again, a good bounce pass. Now that's the time you use that good bounce pass. You see Smith goes up with the left hand to draw the foul.
Clinton Smith makes it a three-point play, and Smith now with 5 points, and it's a 21-20 Cleveland State lead with 5:44 remaining in the first half of action. Another substitution now for the Akron University Zips. The man with the basketball, Mike Dowdell, a 5'10", 160-pound sophomore from Kenmore High School here in Akron. He is also a walk-on. One of the several, as we mentioned, on the Akron University roster. James Merchant on the turnaround. Crawford getting the missed ball. The Vikings now with a chance to add to that one-point lead. Go underneath to Eric Moss. Rejected by Darius Moss. Good block. Ball knocked out of bounds. The Vikings will retain possession.
That was a fine block. As you see here, no head and shoulder fake. Moss comes across and blocks the shot. I think that time, if Eric had that shot back, he would use his left hand that time.
Bob Huggins shouting encouragement to his young Zip team as Steve Corbin goes from downtown and on the rebound. Eric Mudd is going to be called for a personal. We are in the bonus situation and Brian Roth will be at the line for the Zips.
As you see, Eric comes in this time. You see the elbow is out. The hands are not up, so they're going to call a foul every time.
Brian Roth at the line for his first attempt tonight. He's shooting 74% from the free throw line. Missing on the attempt. And the Vikings come away with the basketball, leading 21-20 with 4:53 remaining in the first half. Now I have a foul underneath. Chris Kelly is called for the personal. He was pushing Warren Bradley around, and Warren called it to the official's attention right away.
I think I would too, wouldn't you?
Bradley at 185 pounds gives away 25 pounds to Kelly, who looks like he must have been an offensive lineman. Watch this down on the left of your screen.
Pulling guard there. Hey, you supposed to say something on that. And the Warren's probably saying, hey, I want to get here, but not this way.
Warren Bradley, the freshman from Bridgeport, Connecticut, Bassett High School, puts up his first attempt. He has 1 point now, and it's a 22-20 Viking lead. Bradley averaging 2 points per game and also three rebounds, shooting 46.1% from the line. Bradley makes good on both. And we have Clinton Ramsey coming back into the ball game, giving Eric Mudd a breather, and the Vikings are up 23-20 with 4:41 remaining. We mentioned those free throw shooting percentages, and they sound somewhat anemic, and the Vikings, believe me, know very well that they must improve the foul shooting. While I was sitting here putting my scorecard together for tonight's ball game, Bob Crawford came up and asked me what his free throw shooting percentage was. He grimaced when I told him it was 63.6. All these guys would like to be at about 75% or better.
If you can shoot about 71, 72%, you're doing pretty well.
Darius Moss just threw that ball out of bounds for Akron University. It'll give the ball back to the Vikings and a chance to add on to their three-point lead. Sean Hood directing traffic. Michael Smith getting called for the turnover. And we have now an official timeout with 3 minutes, 54, quite understood what is a zip, but at least we know what a zipper is. A zipper is a kangaroo. They put on quite a show here during the timeout at Akron University. Of course, the Zips would like to put on a better show during the time-ins or the times-in, but the Vikings will put on a better show, hopefully, for the Cleveland State basketball fans. 23-20 right now. They lead by three with 3:52 in the first half. Leading scorers right now, James Merchant, for the Zips has 7 points. Clinton Smith has five for the Cleveland State Vikings.
Although Cleveland State is up by 3 points right now, I'm sure that Coach Mackey is not happy with his ball club tonight.
Well, they have been getting off to some sluggish starts. Save, but right into the hands of Cleveland State. James Merchant trying to avoid the backcourt violation as Clinton Smith pulls up and hits. And now Smith has 7 points, and the Vikings go out on top by five, 25-20 with 3:13 left to go in the first half. There you see on the bulletin board here, the computerized bulletin board, as we have a whistle underneath. There you see a tribute to yours truly, Bingo Smith, my partner, and Alan Davis, who is yours truly. Sean Hood was just called for that personal, and up at the line will be Mike Dowdell. He's a 5'10", 160-pound sophomore from Akron's Kenmore High School, another one of the several walk-ons that they have here on the Akron University basketball team. Dowdell missing the shot, and Cleveland State coming away with the rebound. 25-20 now with 2:43 remaining in the first half.
The defense that the Zips are playing right now is a 4-1. You see the top man, which is number 23, he's not on my roster over here. He goes from top to bottom, so it makes it from a 1-4 to a 2-1-2. That's Russell Holmes.
Russell Holmes, another one of the many walk-ons. That's why some of our rosters are not quite up to date. Holmes is a junior from Mansfield, Ohio, 6'3", 200 pounds. We're down to the 219 mark here at the Akron University Health and Physical Education Center. The Vikings lead by 5, 25-20. And as Darius Moss turns around on the shot from my angle, I thought he had stepped out of bounds. Brian Roth comes away with the rebound, missing, but Roth on the follow-up makes it now 25-22. The Vikings lead is cut to 3. Roth has 8 points.
Someone has to make contact with Roth out there, and he'll do it all night. Fine shot by Clinton Smith out of the
Smith
corner.
Smith now 9 points.
See, that's the shot that we talked about last week that we thought that Clinton should have been taking. He wasn't taking that shot before.
We're down to a minute and a half in the first half. It's a 27-22 Viking lead. Roth again with the rebound, putting it up, missing, and coming out with it is Quentin Ramsey. Quentin Smith pulling up, bouncing off the rim, and on the rebound, Warren Bradley committing the personal. That is Bradley's first. Darius Moss will be at the line for the Zips, who trail by 5 with a minute and 9 seconds remaining. There you see Mel Drummer, one of the academic advisors to the Cleveland State basketball team. He's the gentleman on your left with the sport coat. Moss up and in with his first attempt, shooting 60% from the free throw line. 1 for 1 so far this evening. He's a walk-on, or was a walk-on his freshman year. He's now a junior. Played his high school ball at Chanel High School in Bedford. Eric Mudd back in now. And Moss makes good on both. He's 2 for 2, 6 points now on the evening. And it's 27-24, the Vikings by 3 with just over a minute remaining in the first half of action. Bob Crawford on the turnaround, falling short, and underneath, Roth finally coming away with a rebound. Long pass down to James Merchant. Merchant missing, but he was fouled by Sean Hood, and we had to hold our breath there for a moment because Merchant really took a tumble.
That was a Wesley Onsell outlet pass that time, and Roth has the body to do it. He threw that ball two-hand overhead pretty close to 3/4 of the court. Merchant caught the ball in stride, went in for the shot. He was fouled.
And James Merchant will be at the line for 2 shots. He's perfect so far from the line this evening. 3 for 3, came into the ball game shooting 73% from the free throw line. Missing on his first attempt. Merchant averaging 13.7 points per ball game. He's the second leading scorer on the Zip squad with 151 points total.
You know, you hate to miss a free throw, especially when you take a hard fall missing the layup.
Well, he makes good on the second, so he splits the pair. He's now 4 for 5 on the evening and has 8 points. And the lead by the Vikings is cut to 2 as we're down to the 35-second mark. The Vikings working for the last shot of the first half, hoping to go into the locker room with a 4-point lead.
Now you have to wonder, when would Cleveland State go for this last shot? Will they go to 3 seconds to go and just take the last shot of the half? Or will they try to get 2 shots out of this, go at the shot at eight or nine seconds?
Well, we'll find out pretty quick as Eric Mudd is fighting for the loose basketball, and Quentin Ramsey, as he goes up, is fouled by Rick Accord. Check it. He is not fouled by Rick Accord. It is called a jump ball, so on the alternate possession rule, it'll remain Cleveland State basketball with 4 seconds remaining in the first half. Russell Holmes coming into the ball game now, a 6'3", 200-pound junior. So here is the shot by Vince Richards, blocked by Holmes, and that is the end of the first half with the score. Actually, the program lists him at 7'2" and 255 pounds, the sophomore from Stowe, Ohio. The last time this series between Akron University and Cleveland State goes back 40 games. This is the 40th game. Akron U leads in the series 23-16. The last time CSU and the University of Akron met on the court was on February 8, 1983 in Cleveland's Public Hall. On that occasion, the game was surrounded by controversy. The Vikings won on a last second shot by Lee Reed, 83-82. However, a phantom point had been added to CSU's running score at the 3:31 mark of the first half, and that point was the one which caused the controversy. Although the point couldn't be substantiated, the score stood CSU 83, University of Akron 82. And we have another cliffhanger right here as Brian Roth gets called for the traveling violation. It'll give the ball back to the Vikings.
That's that travel rule. Again, it comes into play just about every game. That's a good first move in the pros, but in college, it's traveling.
And Eugene Miles attempting the shot, missing, but Clinton Ramsey coming away with the rebound and putting the shot up and in. He has 6 points now, and the Vikings go on top by four. Setting the starting lineup for you for the Zips, who now have the basketball. It is Lawyer, Roth, Accord, Schutz, and Merchant. For the Vikings, their original starting lineup as Eugene Miles gets called for his fourth personal right now, and quickly Bob Crawford comes in to replace Eugene.
But Roth did on that play, he set a pick across the lane. As the man broke topside, he broke backside and went to baseline.
Brian Roth on the inbound pass, beautiful play. Roth now has 8 points, and the Zips are back to within two, 29-27, with 19 minutes and 9 seconds remaining in the game. Smith missing, Roth rebounding. And I am impressed with this 6'7", 245 pounders from Sandusky.
As I mentioned before, very good fundamentals. He's open again underneath, they got him the ball.
A transfer from Toledo University. Shooting and missing from long range there. Shoots, saves the ball and passes it out to John Lawyer. A court underneath the Lawyer has it blocked by Clinton Ramsey. Good clean block. The Vikings have the basketball. Hood and Cleveland State on the attack now. Vince Richards falling short. Merchant coming down with the rebound.
You know, when you're a team and you really don't have that much talent, it actually brings the players together. They're actually looking for each other to set picks and screens and go to the basket. Everyone is playing like this is a championship game. Bad pass that time, though.
Clinton Ramsey, 3-on-1 fast break. Ramsey over to Smith. Smith lays it up and in. 11 points for Clinton Smith, his best offensive output in quite some time. And the Vikings now have a 4-point lead, 31-27. We've played less than 3 minutes here in the second half of action. The Vikings with a record of 8-5, looking for their second win of the season on the road. They are 1-4. First victory coming January 5th up in Utica, New York, against the Utica Pioneers. Akron University, as Doug Duke puts up a long jumper.
I guess they figured they had passed enough. It was time to take that jump shot.
The Zips with a record of 5-6, now trailing 31-29 with 17:08 remaining in the ball game. Schutz's career high was 23 points, and that was in a green and white Viking uniform. Richards putting it up and in.
Very fine move that time by Vince. He saw a hole. He snuck down the crease of that hole, went in for the yo-yo jump shot.
33-29 now. The Vikings lead by four as Chris Kelly comes into the ball game replacing Rick Accord. John Hood underneath. Clinton Ramsey puts it up and in. Ramsey with 8 points, and we've seen Clinton Ramsey establish a pattern. He gets really hot the second half, had 26 points against the University of Illinois Chicago, and the majority of those were second half points.
Well, it takes him a half to get warmed up.
Merchant missing, Kelly coming down with the rebound. The Zips retain possession. They trail by six now. Has to be Cleveland State's biggest lead, if my memory serves me correctly. Brian Ross traveled again, shifted that pivot foot.
What you have to do when you're a college player is have good head and shoulders fake. You really can't use that false start, which is a quick step in the pros. You can't do it in college.
The Vikings will get the basketball with 16:14 remaining and a 6-point lead, 35-29. Hoping to add on to it. I want to take this opportunity to wish a happy birthday to my partner's daughter, Monique Smith, who is celebrating a birthday today. We won't say how many because it's not nice to tell a woman's age, no matter
That's
how
true.
Old she is. Quentin Ramsey coming out with the basketball after a scramble there. Vince Richards does what Brian Ross did on the other end, takes that little stutter step and is called for traveling. We have an official timeout on the floor with 15:43 remaining in the contest. The score, Cleveland State 35, Akron University 29. We have 15 minutes and 43 seconds of basketball left here at Akron University. The Akron Zips trailing the Cleveland State Vikings by the score of 35-29. Turnovers, Akron has committed 12, Cleveland State 7. And that may be the margin of difference.
Here we'll see the traveling call. That time we saw it again in slow motion. That back foot, which was his pivot foot, left the floor before he made the dribble. That's why it's a travel.
The Zips now with the basketball, trailing by 6. The Vikings in a man-to-man defense. Vikings will be on the road once again on Saturday night as they travel to Northern Iowa to take on the Panthers and resume their MQA conference schedule. And on Monday night, it's on to Macomb, Illinois to meet the Western Illinois Leathernecks. We'll have both those games for you here on WCLQ. Saturday night's game beginning at 8:30 at night. And also the Monday night game will be an 8:30 start, I believe. I'm not sure. I don't have the schedule in front of me, but we will keep you advised. Kelly being called for the personal.
Here we'll see the foul coming up here. You see, the Vikings has a lot of patience. They're moving the ball. They're looking for people. That time, I think it was an accidental run in. The referee turned around to catch it just at the end.
Nevertheless, it still hurts, and I'm sure that Steve Corbin will be nursing his bruises tonight. That's a lot of basketball player to run into. Chris Kelly, 6'4", 210. He looks a lot bigger than that.
Yes, he does.
Crawford passing it back to Ramsey, and Ramsey can't control it. It'll be Akron University's basketball.
What the Vikings are going to try to do now, they're going to try to put pressure all over the court. They're going to play man-to-man defense and pressure to try to stop some of this crisp passing that the Zips are doing now.
They knocked the ball out of bounds there, and the Zips retained possession, however. Ross getting out of that trap set for him by Ramsey and Mudd. And the Zips bring the ball into their front court. There hasn't been too much scoring the last couple minutes. Roth on the turnaround, off the glass, no good. Mudd coming down with the rebound. Vikings on the attack. Crawford stopping. It goes off, but Crawford is called for the offensive foul, and I have to sort of question that call.
Well, I think Bob was a little far down onto the baseline that he couldn't get the angle right that he really wanted to the hoop. At that position there, you got to have a nice little soft hook shot that he can slow down and take the little hook shot.
And he did lean in, so I will stand corrected and apologize to the officials, which is something that I don't often do.
That's true.
Bob Crawford now with two personal fouls and a steal by Eddie Bryant. Bryant's going to stop, pulls up and puts it in.
That's only the third steal and conversion for a basket for Cleveland State. That's unusual.
Eddie Bryant's first 2 points make it 37-29. The Vikings up by 8 with 13:56 remaining. The Akron University Zips have called a timeout, and we'll be back.
The defense shifts on this press. The four man, which is Eddie Bryant, comes from behind, to steal this basketball, to go down and make a score. Very fine defensive play.
And that puts the Vikings up by 8 now, as we mentioned. Leading scorer so far in the ballgame, Clinton Smith with 11 points for the Vikings. Clinton Ramsey follows him with 8. Merchant and Roth have 8 points each for the Akron University Sips. Darius Moss has 6. And tomorrow night on Channel 61's 8 p.m. movie, Mystery Week continues. It's Christopher Plummer as a modern-day pirate in Desperate Voyage.
This is the time that the Vikings must try to pull away. They must play their best defense of the game right now to try to establish at least a 15-20-point lead.
Merchant really fought for that one, and he finally got it. 10 points for James Merchant. Brings the Zips to within 6. As Ramsey drives the baseline, missing, but Mudd comes away with the rebound. He puts it up off the glass. Crawford puts it over, and they are saying it is no good. And they're going to call Crawford for an offensive foul.
I think it was a late call. As you see here, Mudd with the shot. As you see, Crawford came from the back. He leaned in on that, but it was a late call, I think.
Boy, the Viking bench did not like that at all, as Warren Bradley gets set to come in, and he is going to be playing the center position right now. I believe he'll be coming in for Bob Crawford. Underneath, Darius Moss almost dunked it, but he was blocked.
But not tonight. Steve said not tonight.
Steve Corbin showing his fine leaping ability. As
that was a very fine pass for a big man to see all over the court. I think he took his time. It was too easy for him. And when it's too easy, you can mess up and something bad can happen.
Darius Moss will be at the line for 2 shots. He makes good on the first one. He now has 7 points on the evening and is a perfect 3-for-3 from the free throw line, where he was shooting 60% coming into the ball game. Misses on that one. So the Zips cut the Viking lead down to 5 now with 12:55 remaining in the contest. It is 37-32, a low-scoring ball game as far as Cleveland State basketball games go. The Vikings are now ranked 7th nationally in scoring by the NCAA with an 84.5 point per game average. They'll fall short of that tonight, barring some miracle here.
As you can see on the defense, as you see, Schultz, number 32, he goes up and down the lane, the middle lane. He is the run man. This is actually a 1-4, and he goes from up to back, up to back.
Rob coming down with that rebound of a Ramsey miss, and the Zips once again on the attack as Merchant puts it up, misses, but shoots, follows up and puts it in.
I think Merchant wiped everybody out on that play. No one could get the rebound but his own teammate.
It's 34-37 as Schutz on the other end does us a favor by committing his 3rd personal foul. Schutz, who started his collegiate career at Cleveland State University, perhaps looking to try to make life miserable for his former teammates, has a little bit of extra incentive. You know, talking about Doug Schutz brings to mind the fact that of 5 of those players on that 8-20 squad, the final year of Ray Derringer's tenure, as Corbin misses there, and coming out with a rebound is John Lawyer. 5 of those starters on that squad are now starting elsewhere. A whistle on the other end, and we have Merchant hurt, limping around a little bit. James Merchant, a 180-pound junior from Oberlin, Ohio.
They can't afford to lose him, that's for sure.
And what is the decision?
I think he's going to stay in.
There was some question as to whether they were going to call a timeout. Now let's finish out what I've been trying to say, is that of those people on that 8-20 squad, 5 of them are starting elsewhere. Dave Colbert starts at Dayton. Jim Less starts at Bradley. Vince Richards, of course, is starting for the Vikings. Doug Schutz here at Akron. And we have a 5th player, and that'll get that.
That's a lot of men. That's a lot of men to be playing behind. You have to play him to the side.
Yeah. 37-36 now, the Viking lead cut to one. The Vikings have seen 7 unanswered points by the Akron University Zips. Mudd on the turnaround falls short. Ball knocked out and saved by John Lawyer. The crowd comes alive here at the Health and Physical Education Center on the University of Akron campus. The Zips have come from 8 down, and they now trail by 1. Merchant gives them the lead, and he is fouled.
He was an All-American in junior college. He can put on a show. Here you see the spin move by Merchant. The shot is released. Very good wrist. He knew it was in all the time.
That foul was called on Warren Bradley, as you see Kevin Mackey getting ready to send Clinton Ramsey in. James Merchant was Bob Huggins' first recruit when he took over here at Akron University, and he just made good on his 5th out of 6 free throw attempts. He had 13 points, and the Zips are up by 2 over the Vikings.
You mentioned that was his first recruit and last for that year. He only had 1.
He's had to make do with a lot of walk-ons here as the Akron University Zips in the throes of a probation placed on him by the NCAA. Clinton Ramsey on the turnaround, his 10th point of the ball game. Now it's a 39-39 contest with 10 minutes, 17 seconds remaining. And we're going to have a whistle and a traveling violation call on Darius Mudd.
That's a questionable call because that ball was really not in his hand. It was not a ball that he had control of. So when he made the little jabber step, the ball was actually loose.
I thought initially when he blew the whistle, it could have been a foul on Warren Bradley, but it's nice to see that the official does give a break to the visiting team every so often. Bradley on the rebound has the ball knocked out of bounds, and it'll be Akron University's basketball as Merchant comes back in, replacing Rick Accord, who spelled him momentarily. Warren Bradley, number 32, a freshman from Bridgeport, Connecticut, attended Warren Harding High School, where his teams went 55-1 during his time there.
That was a smart move by Doug that time. The time was running out for the out-of-bounds pass, so he threw it off Clinton Smith.
Darius Moss has a shot blocked by Bradley. And we have a foul call now, and it'll be on Vince Richards.
I think Moss tried to make up his mind. What does he really want to do? A straight layup or a dunk? He takes his time here. He's too relaxed on this. You have to explode off of this. That time he was under the hoop and tried to dunk it. He's going to get a dunk sooner or later, I hope.
Bob Crawford, number 40, coming in replacing Warren Bradley as Brian Roth goes to the line for 2 shots. Brian Roth so far in the evening 0-for-1 from the free throw line. He's shooting 74% there, and he is 1-for-2 now. And he has 11 points on the evening. The Zips go on top by 1 with 9:45 remaining. Roth is good on the second one. He has 12 points, and the Zips lead is now 2. On the steal, stops, and Hood saves it by knocking the ball out of bounds. And it'll still be Akron University's ball, but saved what could have been a sure 2 points on that fast break.
That was a very good defensive play by Sean Hood that time, although I think that if Merchant had taken the ball all the way to the hoop, he had a head start. He pulled up, I think it was a little slip or something, but he should have went straight to the hoop.
Lawyer on the fake, misses, but he's fouled by Ramsey. Clinton Ramsey committing his second personal, and Lawyer will be at the line for 2 shots.
Ramsey is probably saying, I never touched it, but anytime you take a swipe, they're going to call it if the shot is missed. You have to go straight up, arms extended, hand extended straight over your head. You can't bring it forward, or they'll call that every time.
Lawyer shooting 80% from the free throw line, has not scored tonight, but he does now. With that, his first attempt. It is now 42-39. The Akron University zips up by three and make it four as Lawyer pans them both. 43-39 now. The Akron University zips up by four over the Cleveland State Vikings. 9 minutes, 10 seconds remaining. The Zips a good defense. And Sean Hood coming away with a rebound as Ramsey goes up off the glass. No good. Crawford puts it up and in. Good effort on the offensive board by the Zips. Crawford putting in the basket, and it's now 43-41. The Vikings trailing by two.
The Vikings are putting a little more pressure on the whole court defense. They're trying to cause a turnover so they can get some points off this press.
A reminder that if you would like to support Cleveland State basketball, your chance can come when you can join the Fast Breakers Club. For more details, you can call 687-4800. Ask for Robin for the details. Brian Roth, 14 points now. That is his average for the season. And it is 45-41 as Richards counters with a jump shot from the other end. Vince Richards now with 6 points. And it's 45-43 in favor of Akron University. The next meeting of the Fast Break Club, Monday, January 28th at noon at Keepers on the west side, West 25th and Detroit to be specific. That is the same day of the Cleveland State-Kent State basketball game, the return encounter. Doug shoots, is blocked by Kent Ramsey. Ramsey committing his third personal, and Schutz will be at the line for a 1-1.
This is not Ramsey's night. He's normally our most consistent player. Things are not going right for him tonight. He's missed some easy shots underneath that he normally will convert and get three-point plays off. Tonight they're not falling for him, and it's kind of affecting him on the defensive end.
And you could tell by the expression on his face, he was not very happy with that call. Schutz missing on the 1-1. Merchant coming away with the rebound. He puts it up. He misses. And this time it's Ramsey coming down with the rebound.
Got away with a little elbow that time also.
Clinton Smith not falling. The Vikings shooting percentage is very, very poor this evening, but not really because they've been taking bad shots. They just haven't been falling in. Merchant missing. And Roth coming out with the rebound. He puts it up and in. Brian Roth having a very good night with 16 points thus far on the evening. It's 47-43. The Zips up by four with 7 minutes exactly remaining in the contest.
That was just very good hustle on Roth's part that time. The ball was actually kept in play by a teammate.
Ramsey had the ball stripped away, and there was no call. He was looking for it. Kevin Mackey yelling at the officials that the calls are ridiculous. Complaining because the Vikings are getting fouled, or so he claims, and the whistles aren't coming. 6.5 remaining at the 4-point Akron University lead as Roth misses. Darius Moss on the rebound is fouled by Eddie Bryant.
That was a hustle foul by Moss that time. When you get a foul like that, your coach is not going to argue with you, not going to question your judgment on that. He was going for the offensive tip, so that's a good hustle on his part.
Foul was on Moss. It is his second. There is a timeout on the floor with 6 minutes, 24 seconds remaining. The score, Akron University 47, Cleveland State 43. We'll be back into the huddle of the Cleveland State Vikings, rather the Akron University Zips, as you see Coach Bob Huggins diagramming the play.
What Coach Huggins mentioned in that hole was, on offense, let's keep the ball moving. We're making good cuts, but the ball is not reversing quick enough so we can hit that man underneath. I think what Cleveland State had to do, once they pass the ball to the corners, Sean Hood or Vince Richards must go through to create something. They're standing, so the ball is just reversing back and give them the defense time to set up.
The shooting percentages reflect the situation. Cleveland State shooting only 36.7% on 18 of 49 from the field, and Akron University shooting 17 of 42% for 40.5. So neither team shooting very well, but right now the Akron University Zips have the upper hand with a 4-point lead and less than 6 minutes remaining in the contest. Steve Corbin has it called for a foul, stole the ball, or thought he did anyway, and it's called for a second personal, and that'll send Brian Roth to the line.
Well, that was a good hustle on his part. The ball was loose. It was a bounce pass. It didn't come up the way Roth really wanted the ball to, so everyone had a chance to go for it. Unfortunately, we got called for a foul.
The Zips with a chance to build on their 4-point lead as Roth puts his first up shot up and in. Roth now 3 for 4 from the free throw line. And he misses on his second attempt, so he's 3 for 5. 17 points for Brian Roth. He dips up by 5. And Bob Crawford missing the opportunity for a slam there. And it'll be Akron University's ball once again.
Sometimes it's easy just to make a layup. It looked good for the fans to dunk, but the best thing to do is make a layup. A fine steal by Eddie Bryant.
Good layup, and Eddie Bryant now has 4 points. It's 48-45. The Vikings within 3. Brian Roth, the scoring leader for the Zips with 17 points. And he's had a high of 20 so far this season. That came in a 75-61 loss to Youngstown State. Eugene Miles and Eric Mudd coming into the ball game, and Bob Crawford. James Merchant will be on the line. Merchant missing. Corbin coming down with the rebound.
That last foul also was on Corbin.
Ramsey missing again. Ramsey cannot buy a basket. And it'll be Akron University's basketball. And it's getting down to nail-biting time here, Bingo. Less than 5 minutes remaining. The Vikings trail by 3. Ball saved and stolen by the Vikings, and Eric Mudd with a good effort putting it up and in. 5 points for Mudd, 48-47. Now a steal by Ramsey, up and in, and the Vikings once again with the lead. This is what we mean by the excitement of Cleveland State basketball. The Vikings never quit.
Both times they tried to enter the ball down the middle. Once was a short pass and the other was a little long. A good play that time by Merchant.
And Merchant gives the Vikings, puts the Zips back into the lead, 50-49. Merchant now with 15 points. It's been that wrecking crew, the 1-2 scoring punch of Roth and Merchant that have taken care of the offensive chores for Akron University. They have 32 points between the two of them. Ramsey has the ball taken away. And he wants a call, but he's not getting it.
Well, when the defensive player is already set, no matter what you do, that time Clinton tries to force the play, and you can't do that. Sometimes you have to pass the ball back out and try to get a better position on your next shot.
3:40 remaining. Time now becomes of the essence. 50-49, Akron U on top as Corbin almost stole it. Merchant getting away with it, though, and missing the shot, but Eugene Miles coming down with the rebound. It's the Vikings once again on the attack. They trail by 1. Mudd now with 7 points. Eric Mudd, who was scoring in double figures early in the season, his point production has tailed off somewhat, but he's coming through with the crucial baskets when we need them tonight. And Akron University quickly calls a timeout. 3:08 remaining in the lead. The Cleveland State Vikings 51, the Akron University Zips 50.
There you saw a fine pass by Eddie Bryant that time. He split the defense, made a very fine bounce pass, That time I thought Eric took one too many dribbles. He should have went straight up with the ball the time he got it, but it worked out okay for us.
Free throws are going to be a factor going down the stretch run here. Akron University has only three team fouls. They have five, three more to give away before they go into the bonus. The Cleveland State Vikings have already put Akron University into a bonus situation as Corbin makes a nice steal, breaks up the pass, but it'll still be Akron University's basketball. In their last two ball games, the Zips have scored 52 and 51 points. They have 50 here tonight. Eddie Bryant knocking that one away.
That last pass, that cross-court pass, is the pass that the Vikings want the Zips to take. So they have a chance to steal that basketball. What the Zips have to do is try to make forward passes, advance the ball up the court.
The Vikings, speaking of scoring, have scored 72 points in the loss to Illinois-Chicago, 82 and 83 in victories over Eastern Illinois and Wisconsin-Green Bay as Ramsey makes a steal. It's Ramsey and Mudd, two on one. Ramsey passes off the Mudd. Mudd too hard off the glass on the rebound. We've got a foul on Clinton Ramsey, I believe. Check it. It's Steve Corbin.
Here we see Ramsey lost control of the basketball. A good pass to Mudd. Jump stop. Foul on Steve. He went over the back. He should have taken one extra step to try to get equal with the defensive player before he went up.
That'll put Darius Moss at the line. Moss with 7 points tonight, 3 for 4 from the free throw line, where he's shooting 60%. He misses on that attempt, and that'll give the ball back to Cleveland State University, trailing by 1 point with 2.5 minutes remaining. Vikings now going into a spread. The Zips remain in their zone, although Lawyer is inching out ever so slightly.
He's the one man. He's the top man on that 1-4. The Zips will play three different type defense. They'll play a 1-4, then they go back to a 1-3-1, and then they'll come out with a 2-3. So they'll change each time to camouflage their weaknesses on defense.
We're now within the 2-minute mark. Vikings trailing by one. We'll keep an eye on the game and an eye on the clock for you. Eddie Bryant losing the basketball and Akron University coming away with it with 1:40 to go. Again, the Cleveland State bench bemoaning the fact that there was no call as Eddie Bryant fell on that drive.
I thought it was a little tripping that time, but you can't really argue with the official when you make the mistake of trying to go through two individuals. I think he should have held that ball and passed it and started the offenses over again.
We have a timeout called by the University of Akron Zips with 1:16 remaining. The score, Akron U 51. The strategy that they're going to employ for the last 1:16 of the ball game, and basically what will that be?
With the personnel that they have, they could try to keep the ball and take the last shot of the game. But without a big rebounding team, they may go at it a little early, hoping that if they miss and don't get the rebound, they have one more chance if they can put a good defensive effort on the other end. So I look for them to take this shot, not down at 10 or 9 seconds, but a little earlier than that.
Inbounds it goes to John Lawyer with 1:14 now. The clock ticking away as Eddie Bryant knocks the ball out of bounds. And he thought for a minute that he had gotten called for a foul. And I think, Bingo, just a personal observation that sometimes the guys are playing a little tentative now because they're concerned about that official's whistle.
Well, that's true. We've had some calls tonight that was questionable, but have been going both ways, though. So they should just play heads-up basketball and try not to lose their poise and patience out here. Hope to get a steal, if not a rebound on this shot.
Eugene Miles. Now Brian Robb gets called for the foul. And that's a break for the Vikings. Let's see whether they can take advantage of it. Roth with only his first personal of the ball game, and that'll give the ball back to the Cleveland State Vikings as Russell Holmes gets set to come into the ball game, and he replaces Brian Roth. So the Zips going with quickness now as opposed to size. 49 seconds remaining in the ball game.
I think they're going to press because they really don't want Cleveland State to hold this basketball down for the last shot. So they put a fast team out here who can really press.
And Eugene Miles is fouled by James Merchant. Merchant doesn't like the call, but all of a sudden now the Zips have five team fouls this second half. But they can afford to give away a couple more before they get into the bonus situation. Miles, Mudge, Eddie Bryant, as Miles tries to bring that ball down court. Clinton Ramsey and Steve Corbin, and this time it is Holmes committing the personal. Check it, John Lawyer.
We were fortunate on that play. That was the exact play that he lost the ball on, so that time the break went our way that time. You never should try to split two defensive people. If not, slow the ball down and try to pass the ball forward.
Now the next personal foul will be the bonus situation. 36 seconds to go. Vikings trailing by one, and now we do have a bonus situation as Lawyer commits the personal, and that'll send Steve Corbin to the line.
Coach Mackey is want an intentional foul call here so he can get two guaranteed shots. They're only going to give him a one and one. So this first shot will tell if this was a good strategy or not.
Steve Corbin shooting 73.3 from the line as Clinton Smith now replaces Clinton Ramsey in the Viking lineup. Mudd, Smith, Richards, Corbin, and Miles. Corbin at the line, 73.3% free throw shooter.
Now Akron is trying to say that Eddie Bryant had the ball.
Corbin with a 4.3 point per game average. Has not scored tonight. Does there though. And it is now a tie ball game as Brian Roth comes in replacing Russell Holmes. 52-50 now, the Vikings on top. Missing on the second attempt, and the Zips now with a chance to tie the ball game. And James Merchant brings it across midcourt, and he takes a timeout with 27 seconds remaining. The score, Cleveland State 52, Akron University 50. We'll be back. Well, I changed my mind. We're going to keep it here.
Well, I think what the Zips is probably talking over in their hole right now, when should we take this last shot? Should it be where we get ourselves another opportunity at it? Or should we just sell for the last shot of the game? I think they'll probably take this shot with about 9 or 10 seconds to go to give themselves a chance to get a rebound and put it back in. If not, commit a foul to give them the one and one on the other end and hope to get back in the game that way.
There you look at the two huddles. Good camera work by our camera crew here.
As you see, Coach Mackey is saying, be strong with the basketball. Once you get the ball back, be strong with the basketball.
Coach Bob Hummings, the first year head coach of the Akron University Zips. They had a rough time of it. Hardly any scholarship to speak of. Four walk-ons on the basketball club. And still, he's managed to put together a 5-6 record, which I think is the end of the world.
This basketball game, and it's very well possible he could lose with 27 seconds left. He should feel proud of his players with four walk-ons, two football players, and guys he got out of the bleachers today that we didn't even have on our roster. So he has nothing to be ashamed of. I think his team played very well tonight.
52-50 the score. The Vikings on top by the slimmest of margins. 27 seconds remain. Akron University will have the basketball.
You know, Steve Corbin was in the doghouse for a couple of games there. He didn't get enough, a lot of playing time. I don't know what the problem was that he was not playing, but I think tonight his performance and his clutch free throw the last 27 seconds may get him back in this ball game a lot more now.
Doug shoots to John Lawyer, to James Merchant. Down to 20 seconds now, as you see on the upper left-hand corner of your screen. Merchant taking the shot. No good. It goes out of bounds. It'll be Cleveland State basketball. Dave Smith was the player who knocked that ball out of bounds as Eric Mudd tries to get the ball inbound, and he does, and he is called for a 5-second violation. Mudd not getting help in time. We're down to 12 seconds, and the Zips have the basketball.
I think what happened on that, they're so used to everyone getting down the court and having one point guard bring it up. So that time when the ball was turned over, you saw Smith and Mudd and the rest of them head down court. You have to take a look sometime and see if you need help.
And with the ball underneath the basket, I would venture to guess that double zero will be getting that lob pass inbounds and trying to get that ball up and in. Brian Roth, we're speaking of, the 6'7", 245-pound senior from Sandusky, Ohio, who leads the Akron U scoring parade with 17 points. In fact, he leads all scores. And James Merchant, his counterpart, with 15. They are the two leading scorers in the ball game so far.
Well, they might try that little Wilt Chamberlain play they used early in the game from out of bounds, where they flipped the ball right up toward the basket and Roth put it in the last time. So we got to look out for that. Also, they set very good screens down low. So if he sets a real good screen on the opposite side of the lane, look for him to post up and hope to get the ball to him.
The Ewing family learned that Jock has instituted a plan which can dramatically affect Ewing Oil tomorrow night at 7 on Dallas. And you can see Dallas every evening, Monday through Friday at 7 o'clock here on WCLQ TV 61. Right now, we're down to 13 seconds in this ball game. The Vikings leading 52-50 over the Akron University Zips. Doug shoots, inbounds to James Merchant. Merchant looking for the shot. Stolen by Bryant, he loses it out of bounds. Eddie Bryant, you can see the look of frustration on his face.
That was a play like in football where the official is part of the court. He tried to not run over the official and lost the basketball.
9 seconds to go. Merchant looking for a shot, puts it up. It is missed, and coming down with a rebound is Cleveland State with 2 seconds to go. We have a jump ball on the alternate possession. It'll give the ball to Cleveland State. The Vikings want to call a timeout with 2 seconds remaining, and they are going to talk strategy. What are they going to do the last 2 seconds? And probably, I would venture to guess, Bingo, the best thing to do would just be to throw it down the length of the court and at least hope somebody touches it, because whatever happens, it's going to knock 2 seconds off the clock.
That's true. I think that's their strategy, to get the ball farther away from this basket down here as possible and not foul. It's kind of surprised me that they called a timeout with 2 seconds, but we saw what happened a few seconds ago when they couldn't get the basketball in with 5 seconds. So Coach Mackey want to make sure, say, hey, you guys, if we can't get anybody open right around, we're going to throw it down court. It'll take them longer than 2 seconds to bring it back.
I'm going to take a look at that steal again. Merchant.
A very good head and shoulder fake. As you see, Eddie came from the weak side. He was watching the play all the way. I think if that official hadn't been there, he had a possible chance of recovering the basketball, but it was a very good hustle play on his part.
And one of the things that Merchant didn't do, as you notice, and I'm sure, Bingo, you would advise this to a younger player, he looked at the pass and he telegraphed it just by the look on his face.
Yes, he did. What happened, the defense dictated to him where the pass was going to go. They had him boxed off on the baseline. He couldn't go across the lane for a pass, so he had to go outside. And Eddie Bryant read that pass very careful, and he made the interception.
See, I'm learning a little bit working with you. And the Vikings have called another timeout.
I think some of those guys forgot what he said, so he's making sure.
And let's break away right now for a commercial message. We'll be back with the last exciting 2 seconds of this contest right after this. Averaging 84.5 points per ball game. That is good for seventh best in the nation. But the Vikings, nevertheless, hopefully will come away with a victory here tonight against the University of Akron. Zips 52-50. The last time, as we mentioned, They defeated Akron University 83-82 thanks to a phantom point that was never substantiated, but nevertheless the victory stood. And if the Vikings do hold on and win, it'll be only their 17th victory in 40 tries against the Akron University Zips. There is the shot. It is thrown down court. And nobody touched it. The Zips still have life.
Boy, I don't think this game is going to ever end. This last 2 seconds has been, 15 minutes?
It sort of reminds me of that Georgetown-Villanova game that was on television last Saturday, where it took about 5 minutes to run off 16 seconds off the clock.
I think the strategy was if you could get the basketball in close, then someone take off. That time, the out-of-bound personnel saw the man take off, and he just threw it.
The Zips said it's touched by Eric Mudd and knocked out of bounds, but no second was ticked off the clock. So it'll still be Akron U's basketball. Dave Smith, the long shot, it is missed, and the game is over. The Cleveland State Vikings escape with a victory, 52-50. We'll be back with the recap right after this. Education Center on the campus of the University of Akron, where the Vikings have escaped with a victory 52-50 over the Zips. And Bingo, we're going to take a look at that last shot and see what happened here.
You see, the pass is in. It's a long pass. They tried to get the ball inside the Roth. They couldn't. The jump shot, which was about a 26-footer, was just barely missed. It's off the rim. We win the game.
Okay, quickly recapping the score for the Akron University Zips. Brian Roth with 17, James Merchant with 15, Doug Schutz with 7, Darius Moss with 7, John Lawyer with 2, and Dave Smith with 2. For the Vikings, it was Clinton Ramsey with 12, Clint Smith with 11, Eric Mudd with 7, Vince Richards with 6, Bob Crawford with 4, Eugene Miles with 3, Warren Bradley with 2, Sean Hood with 2, and Steve Corbin with 1. And that makes the final score 52-50. The Vikings now 9-5 and will now play Northern Iowa on Saturday night. We'll have that game for you here on WCLQ beginning at 8:30 p.m. So for Bingo Smith, this is Alan Davis saying goodbye from the campus of Akron University, where the final score once again was Cleveland State 52, Akron U 50. Good night, everybody.
Tonight's game has been brought to you by these fine sponsors. The Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company, maker of the new Victor Radio. It simply performs like no other tire in the world. Budweiser, the king of beers. Reach for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. Revco Discount Drug Centers, where everyday low discount prices mean you'll get it for less. You need all the Revco you can get. Curtis Mathis Home Entertainment Centers, with the exclusive 4-year limited warranty. Daniels, Cleveland's headquarters for fine, affordable furniture. And Bedford Toyota, the oasis at the entrance of the Bedford Auto Mile, Broadway and Rockside. This has been a WCLQ-TV sports presentation.
Hello, I'm Michael Landon. If you're between the ages of 45 and 70...